Hello children, in this video I am going to explain exercise 3.2, that is your trigonometric function. Already I have explained 3.1 in previous two videos, where angles and their measurement, then after degree measurement, radian measurement and conversion of degree to radian and radian to degree be explained. And questions of 3.1 already I have explained in previous two videos. Now I am going to explain exercise 3.2, that is trigonometric function. Now children, in earlier classes we have studied trigonometric ratios for acute angles as the ratio of sides of a right angle triangle. This is your right angle triangle, perpendicular, base and hypotenuse. You already know sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosec theta, sec theta and cot theta. Six trigonometric functions are there. Sine theta is equals to P upon H, cos theta B upon H, tan theta P upon B. Cosec is H upon P, sec theta H upon B and cot theta B upon P. Now, we are going to study trigonometric function. For that, consider a unit circle with center at origin of the coordinate axis. This is your coordinate axis and a circle is made whose radius is 1 unit. A circle is made whose radius is 1 unit. Now just see children, here 4 quadrants are there. Here the coordinates are, point A is 1, 0, because this length is 1 unit. Therefore, this point is 1, 0. Point B is 0, 1, because again this length is radius of the circle and that is 1 unit. So, this is 0, 1. Point C is, length is 1 unit, but the point is -1, 0. And the point D is 0, -1. Consider a point P lies on circumference of a circle. And let this point is A, B. Definitely this perpendicular distance is B and this distance is A. As this point is A, B, then this distance is A and this is your B. And the line which passes through origin and join P, that length is OP and it is called hypotenuse of this triangle. And this length is under root A square plus B square. But since again it is a radius, therefore its unit is 1. Clear? Now, same thing I have written here. For each real number theta, let PA, B be the point on the circle such that OP makes an angle theta with the positive direction of x-axis. Now, we define sine function. Sine function, it is definitely sine, as sine theta is equals to y coordinate of OP. Sine theta, y coordinate of OP. Already I discussed, okay. And cosine function is denoted by cos and it is written as cos theta is equals to x coordinate of P. Okay. In figure, it is clear that points A, B, C, D, already I defined, are 1, 0, 0, -1, 0, and 0, -1. Just see. We observe the following conditions. Sine 0 degree is equals to y coordinate of point A, 0. Here, y coordinate is 0 and the angle is 0 degree. Therefore, sine 0 degree is equals to 0. And cos 0 degree is equals to 1. Okay. Same as this angle is, total angle is pi by 2. So at point B, the angle is theta is equals to pi by 2. Therefore, sine pi by 2 is equals to y coordinate of point B. Here, sine pi by 2 is y coordinate of B and it is equals to 1. Now, at point C, theta makes an angle pi. Therefore, sine pi is equals to y coordinate of point C and it is 0. At point D, theta makes an angle 3 pi by 2. Therefore, y coordinate of point D is minus 1. Hence, sine 3 pi by 2 is equals to minus 1. Now, when theta comes to point A, it makes an angle 2 pi and again sine 2 pi is equals to 0. And then after angle complete one rotation, we followed him. Clear? Similarly, cos 0 degree is equals to x coordinate, that is 1. Cos pi by 2, x coordinate at B is 0, therefore it is 0. Cos pi, x coordinate of point C, that means it is minus 1. Cos 3 pi by 2 is at point D of x coordinate, it is 0. Is it clear? The first point A represent cos and second point B represent sine. So now we observe that y coordinate of point A and C are 0. Let's see, y coordinate of point A and C are 0 and this is your sine function. So sine theta is equals to 0, for theta is equals to 0, plus minus pi, plus is for anticlockwise direction, upward direction, minus is for downward direction, that means clockwise direction, plus minus 2 pi, plus minus 3 pi, that implies when theta is an integral multiple of pi. Okay, and the second observation is x coordinate of the points B and D are 0. Just see here, x coordinate of point B and D are 0 and it is valid for cos. So cos theta is equals to 0 for theta is equals to pi by 2. Just see here, at B the theta is equals to pi by 2 and at D the theta is equals to 3 pi by 2. Hence, cos theta is equals to 0 when theta is equals to plus minus pi by 2, plus minus 3 pi by 2, plus minus 5 pi by 2, dot dot dot. Every angle is children considered as plus and minus, anticlockwise and downward direction clockwise. When theta is odd multiple of pi by 2, just see here 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Therefore, it is odd multiple of pi by 2. And here 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, dot, dot, dot. Integral multiple of pi. This is a pattern, children. Okay? Generalization of the sine and cos angle. The pattern is here for sine. When sine is 0, it is integral multiple of pi. And when the cos theta is 0, then definitely it will be the odd multiple of pi by 2. Now, therefore, the general form is sine theta is equals to 0, which implies theta is equals to n pi, where n belongs to z, z means integer. Cos theta is equals to 0, that implies theta is equals to 2n plus 1 pi by 2, because it is odd multiple of pi by 2, where n belongs to z. Now, for tan theta, we know that it is sine theta by cos theta. That implies since numerator upon denominator, denominator should not be 0. Therefore, definitely, cos theta is not equals to 0. Then, it implies theta is not equals to 2n plus 1 pi by 2. Since it is a rational function, therefore we have to define the domain. Clear? Now, we know that one complete revolution sustains an angle of 2 pi radian at the center of the circle. one complete revolution makes 2 pi angle. Clear? If we take one complete revolution from point P, we again come back to the same point P. One complete revolution, then after again, that means the point is, the revolution is for second revolution, again we come to point P. ठीक है. Thus, we observe that if theta increases by any integral multiple of 2 pi, if theta complete 1, 2 pi, if theta increase by any multiple of 2 pi, that means upward direction, the value of sine and cosine functions do not change. This is 2 pi. Upward direction. That means in this quadrant plus sine and cos do not change. Okay, so if the angle lies upward direction of this point, this is considered as 2 pi plus theta, and in this direction it is 2 pi minus theta. Okay, so now for any integral value of n, sine 2n pi plus theta is equals to sine theta, and cos 2n pi plus theta is equals to cos theta. Now, periods of trigonometric function. We shall now understand the meaning of periodic function. In simple words, a period function is a function that repeats its value in regular intervals or periods. And periodic function, a function f says that d tends to r is said to be a periodic if there exists a non-zero real number such that fx plus a is equals to fx for all x belongs to d. And period of periodic function, let f says that d tends to r be a domain and range, be a positive function, periodic function, the least positive real number p such that fx plus p is equals to fx for all x belongs to d is period of f. One complete revolution, second complete revolution, okay, this is your period of periodic function. Now, the most important thing, sign of trigonometric function. There are four quadrants. The first quadrant represents 0 to pi by 2. And in first quadrant, both the points are plus. That means cos theta is plus and sin theta is plus. Hence, tan theta is always be positive. Then all six trigo functions are positive from 0 to pi by 2. Now just see here pi by 2 to pi. The points are -1, 0 and here -, plus. Minus for cos and plus for sin. Then in second quadrant pi by 2 to pi, cos theta is negative. Hence sec theta is also negative. Sin theta is positive, therefore cosec theta is positive. And since tan is sine by cos, that means plus upon minus, it is minus, therefore tan is also negative. In first quadrant 0 to pi by 2, all six trigo functions are positive. In second quadrant, pi by 2 to pi, sine is positive and cos is negative. Then after in third quadrant, just see children, it is -, minus. And third quadrant lies between pi to 3 pi by 2, 180 degree to 270 degree. In third quadrant, both are minus sine and cos. Therefore, definitely tan, because minus upon minus is plus, therefore tan is positive here. If tan is positive, then cot is also be positive. Okay, same in fourth quadrant. It is +, -. Plus is for cos and minus is for sin. In fourth quadrant, cos is positive and sin is negative. Hence, tan is negative. clear? If plus theta is there, therefore upper direction of angle 0, yani anti-clockwise direction, it is positive. And minus of theta, downward direction, that means it is, here it is negative. Therefore, cos of minus theta is equals to plus cos theta, and sine of minus theta is equals to minus of sine theta, because here sine is negative. Same, tan of minus theta is equals to minus tan theta. So here I have defined sine of trigonometric function in all quadrant. First quadrant 0 to pi by 2, second quadrant pi by 2 to pi, third quadrant pi to 3 pi by 2, and fourth quadrant 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi. Already I have explained all the sine of all six trigo functions. In first quadrant all are positive, in second quadrant sine and cos are positive, rest are negative. In third quadrant, sine and cos are negative and tan is positive. And in fourth quadrant, sine is negative, tan is negative and cos is positive. Okay, based on this concept, in exercise 3.2, question number 1 to 5 are there. Now I am going to explain one question out of these five. Question is, if cos x is equals to minus 3 by 5, x lies in the third quadrant. Third quadrant, that means pi to 3 pi by 2. And here cos is negative. Just see children, here minus is given. Find the value of other 5 trigonometric functions. Here we have to use identities that we did in 10th standard. Now, cos x is minus 3 by 5. That implies definitely sec x is minus 5 upon 3. We need to find out other 5 trigo functions. That means cos is given. Then we need to find out sine, cosec, sec, tan and cot. So cos is given. Therefore definitely sec is opposite of cos. That is minus 5 by 3. Since we know the identity sine square x plus cos square x is 1. That implies we need to find out sine square x. Therefore, sine square x is equals to 1 minus cos square x. Put the value of cos here, you will get sine square x is equals to 16 by 25. Since square is there, quadratic, therefore sine x is equals to plus minus 4 by 5. Now we need to identify which value is valid for third quadrant. Now imagine, visualize sine x in third quadrant is negative. Because in third quadrant, the sign is minus, comma, minus. Okay, so x lies in third quadrant, therefore sin x is negative. Therefore, we need to pick the value minus 4 by 5 for sin x. If sin x is minus 4 by 5, then definitely cosec x is minus 5 by 4. And tan x is already, if sin and cos are there, then definitely tan x is equals to sin x upon cos x. Minus 4 by 5 upon minus 3 by 5, it will give you 4 by 3. Now just see children, tan is positive here. And definitely in third quadrant, tan is positive. Cot x is equals to 3 by 4, opposite of tan x. Therefore, the value of other 5 trigonometric functions are here. Sec x minus 5 by 3, sin x minus 4 by 5, cos sec x minus 5 by 4, tan x 4 by 3 and cot x 3 by 4. This way children, you have to do question number 1 to 5 of exercise 3.2. Okay, that's it. Thank you.